Everybody, Tangible God is tuning in with you today. Blessings to all my kings and queens. Grand rising all day, every day. What does the universe have to tell us today? Thank you guys for tuning in. If this is your first time tuning in, don't forget to like, boop, vibe. I had to get some music. And subscribe to your girl, Tangible Goddess. I love you guys. Make sure that you are meditating daily, taking care of that beautiful, beautiful body of yours, getting the ample amount of rest and sleep, and just loving yourself as a whole. Yeah, you gotta do it. All right. So I cannot wait till I can go live to see what you guys want to talk about, because right now it's all about me. It's all about me. Forget about a you. So what you gonna do? I mean, what I really mean. I'm only saying that because I can't get no requests. I can't get your questions. None of that. It's just one-sided, so I'm just giving you what spirit is giving me. Okay, my fan is on. It's a little. I got a candle lit. It's fall. It's going into fall, so I can't decide whether I'm hot or cold. I'll be hot 1 minute, cold the next. I just don't know. And now I'm like, I got a candle lit right here, and I'm like, this candle is making me hot. I can't tilt it because I didn't already put, it's a 3-wick candle, and I didn't put two of the wicks out by moving it around. I'm finna put the whole thing out. I like the ambiance and all of that, but it's feeling a little hot in here. So, yeah. Guys, I got this deck. Let me see if I kept the card. Oh yeah, I got it. It's the New Arrow Elements Tarot cards, and they have a spread. So I'm just gonna go with their spread. I be wishing I got a setup where you guys could see my cards, and as I pull them, you know how people do. But my stuff be like, damn, is that why y'all don't watch me? I can't put it on the desk. I could try this. So y'all can see that gets. I just try to work with y'all. But let me see. So there's a spread, and this spread is, it would tell you what are your intentions and how do you want others to see you in the context of what's going on in your life at this time. We're going to pull a card that tells you how do you feel about the situation. I'm not going to read this all to y'all. I be doing the most, so I'm not going to read this because I'm going to tell you as I go along, because if I read it now, then I'm just going to have to read it all over again. So let's just get it together. I like vibing with y'all, don't get me wrong, but I know y'all got shit to do. Okay, y'all got shit to do, so no on your downtime and all of that, y'all could just vibe out with me, rock with your girl. Just get comfortable and take a seat and sit back and listen. I'm just hoping that's what the daily is. Or like I used to do, like if you at work, you be working all day, just pop in your headphones and just listen to your girl. Listen to me. Even though I feel like a lot of my stuff is kind of visual. I think you need to see me to see what the hell I'm really saying. My expressions, because I speak with my face, your expressions and all of that. So if you ain't looking at me, you be like, might not get it. Well, let's see. Hey, everybody got different talents and skills, so you might still get it. Because you know you vibe with your tribe. But let's get this reading popping. Okay, first card we're going to pull is, what are your intentions? And how do you want others to see you in the context of what's going on? Just like that. Shuffle it. Boom! card popped up. We got Ace of Water. Ace of Water. What your intentions and how do you want others to see the context of what is going on? We got Ace of Water. I'm just looking at the little symbols. We got Scorpio. We got Pisces. And I forget what that symbol is. Is that Gemini? Look like. Oh, water. Might be Aquarius. Yeah, Pisces, Scorpio, and no. Wait a minute. Oh, that's Cancer. Pisces, Scorpio, and Cancer. Water signs. Ace of Water. Ace of Water. Let's see, guys. I don't know if y'all know this. I took my tongue ring out. I've been took it out for a while. I don't feel as country as I used to be without it. I feel less country. Ace of Water. First card, Ace of Water. It says, the source of the soul water, the fullness of emotion, union, belief, illumination, completion, freedom, limitless bliss. So that's good. It says the Ace of Water is associated with emotions, intuition, beliefs, sensual pleasures, and the subconscious mind. We reach out beyond our own ego and experience and react to the world and the people around us. It indicates that we are faced with the beginning of a new love or new awareness. A new love and a new awareness. Ace of Water is what your intentions is and how you want others to see you as coming into a newness. Yeah. Sweet, sweet, sweet. A knotwork ring surrounds a single drop, creating ripples as it hit the smooth surface of water. In the background, we see ripples of sunlight shining on the shallow body of water around the central disc or smaller knotworks, medallions, with the elementary symbol of water. The symbol for Venus, the moon, which are aligned with the element and the three water signs of the zodiac. Yeah, the three water signs of the zodiac. That's Pisces, Scorpio, and Cancer. Water signs. Yeah. Beautiful. You're faced with the beginning of a new love or new awareness. So whatever's going on in your life and you want people to understand that you are in a new awareness, a new life. New love, new good things, good emotions, good intuition. Beautiful. I love it. Bam. Okay, so the next card we're going to pull is, how do you feel about your situation? This card gives insight about secrets, dreams, and your shadow self. Water. It says change. Two. So, how you feel about the situation is change. This is inside of your secret dreams and your shadow self. So everybody don't really know this, but you feel about this beautiful intuition and change that, situation. Your intentions is for love, and how you feel about the situation is change. You know that there needs to be a change in order for your situation to work great. You feel that there has to be a change. In the secrets, the dreams, your shadow work, your shadow self. Nobody else know this, but you know that there's got to be a change within you about this situation. And let's just read about change. That's a major Aquarius card, I know. Because it's not no suit. Change. I appreciate you guys. This, you know, really, really appreciate you guys. Patience with me. So that air is up. Here we go. This is an earth card. I guess a tree, earth, kind of see change. Jupiter in Capricorn. For all you well-versed astrology people out there, we got Jupiter in Capricorn. It says the power of opposites, the external circle, yin and yang, flexibility, polarization, transmutation. It could be a risk, an avoidance, missing opportunities, fear of change, and busy work. You know, kind of, you kind of just avoiding the change by being busy, but you know there needs to be a change, or you can be in a state of flexibility, looking at transmuting yourself and changing, allowing yourself to change. It says the card urges us to realize that everything has two sides and to abandon a single outlook. Life is best approached when a certain amount of flexibility on easygoing attitude. So understand that everybody has a point of view. Everybody has lived a different life. So we have different views on different situations. Be understandable, be flexible. You know you need to. You know this. This is how do you feel about your situation? You understand that you have to change and be flexible. It's not just about you. It's about everybody and the people that you interact with. What are their thoughts? How were they raised? Why do they feel the way that they feel? Be flexible and understanding. Yes, both sides. Beautiful. I love it. So the next card we're going to be pulling is how is your material existence affected by the situation? What resources can you call upon for support? How is your material things affected by your situation currently in your life? These cards been popping out. I'm waiting for one to pop out. If not, I will pull a card if nothing decides to pop out, universe. How your material existence affected by this situation, and what resources can you call upon for support? Your gal just gonna pull it. Your gal. You got power. When I see a power card like this, is your manifestation. What you think will be. How's your materialistic is affected by the situation? It says power. Power. You have the power. Your ace of water, your intuition to define how this situation will affect you materially. You can look at it and say, it's going to be bad for me. And guess what? It's going to be bad for you. You can look at it and say, this situation is going to benefit me material wise in the future. And your resource is your power, is your manifestation. You have the power to manifest a good outcome. You have the power to manifest a bad outcome. It's up to you. As far as material things, it's all up to you. So there you have it. Next card we're going to be pulling is air. It says, what do you think or understand about the situation at hand, and who can give you good advice? What do you think about the situation at hand? And who can give you good advice? Yes, you. What you think about it? You. Yeah, you. What you think about the situation at hand? We got abundance. So you think it's abundance. This is a situation at hand. It's beautiful. You think it's good. You think that it's going to be abundant in the end. Awesome. Awesome, awesome. You're using your power correctly to, abundant. And do you know what abundant mean? We all know what abundant mean. Overflowing water. Look at that waterfall. Everything is coming to you. Whatever it is you desire. This is what you understand about this situation. It's going to be abundant. Who can give you good advice? Let me just look at abundance and see if it clarified that. Let's see if it can clarify. That's an earth card. Earth card. It's probably an earth sign that can give you good advice. Abundant. Where is it? Abundant. Is that earth? Oops, the earth. Let's see. Why can't I find it? Oh, that's not earth. That is. Let's see. She's got a line through it. See, earth is the triangle facing down without a line. And I'm going to find out there's a triangle facing down with a line. That's something that says probably, is that fire? Let me see. Okay, it's not water. I would think fire would be up. We've got to find out. Okay, fire is a triangle facing up. So it's probably air. Is it air? Nope, air is the line facing up. So it is earth. Sorry guys, I'm so glad y'all rocking with me, but what you gonna do? What you gonna do? Where you gonna go, huh? What the hell is this card, abundance? I just wanna read about it. It says three, let's see. See, this book don't have no accord, concordance, index, none of that. We're going to find it. Thank you guys for being patient. Empress. That's not right. It's not like this happened to me before. Six. Appreciate you guys. Let's see. And if I could, I would pause the video, but I can't. I cannot. If I pause it, it's gonna stop. And stop it completely. That's this this Apple computer. Abundance. I don't want to stick on that forever, but what you think and understand about the situation at hand, you think and understand that it's going to be abundance in the end of your current situation. You think, and that's what you understand. Who can help you with it? I was going to see if the book would tell me, just to give me a little insight on that. But right now, you think that it's going to be abundant. You have the power to manifest that, which is correct. You're correct in thinking that it's going to be abundant. This very... Let's see, the last card we're going to pull is, okay, this card is going to show you the obstacle that you have to overcome to get where you want to be. So sorry about that last little mix up. Obstacle you're going to have to overcome is, okay. higher fall. The higher fall. The obstacle you're going to have to overcome is the higher fun. The higher fun is Taurus. Yeah, the higher fun is Taurus. So you probably heard this as a Taurus. This is the obstacle you got to overcome somehow, this Taurus. But it may be something more we're going to read just to see a little bit more into this. But I know that in the tarot world, higher fun represents a Taurus. So we're going to see. It opened right up to the Hierophant. It says, Taurus, told you. It says, the principle of teaching and learning, culture, belief systems, instructions, listening to one's own conscience. So the obstacle is going to be listening, learning, and to yourself. It could be a spiritual arrogance. It could be fanaticism. I can't read that word. Dogmatism and bigotry. But yeah, these are the obstacles that you're going to go. It says the Hierophant card represents the belief systems of many rather than personal faith. It stands for the socialization of an individual into a group. Traditionally, the Hierophant has been depicted as Roman Catholic Pope. Today, some religious leaders' figures have been confronted with moral dilemmas. One of the most universally admired figures among religious leaders is the Dalai Lama. To show that there is no single path of faith, he is surrounded with symbols of religions of this world. So, your biggest obstacle is just understanding that there are so many different views and so different methods. You can't just think for yourself. It's going to be for everyone. So, the Hierophant is, in a good way, the principle of teaching, learning, culture, belief systems. Well, the thing went dead. Belief systems, instructions, listening to one own conscience. So your obstacle that's going to be your biggest obstacle with outside forces. Oh, with outside forces, just other people's beliefs and situations. So this is going to be your biggest obstacle, is just listening to what other people are saying. When you know your situation and what's going on, you know everything, the ins and outs of it. Your biggest obstacle is going to be getting over what everybody else is saying about your situation and knowing that you understand what it is, the Hierophant. All these religions and everybody got different views and really how they want to think things should be and how it should go. And you have to be the Hierophant, like the Taurus, and be strong in your beliefs, stubborn almost. That's going to be your biggest obstacle, just hearing everybody's opinion. All right. Now, the end result. Ooh, I didn't expect this reading to be so intense. The end result of this, all this situation, you know your situation, I know mine, we all know our situations. Your end result is, it better be good. Ain't nobody got time for no bad end results. End result, spirit guides, angels, and ancestors, let me shuffle. Let me show you. I'm open the card. All out. I'm getting nervous and a little scared. Two cards. There's too many cards. Fell out. We ain't taking all of them. But end result. Come on now. Come on. Feel like I'm gambling. End result. Knowledge. Can't get no better than that. Your end result is knowledge. The end result is knowledge. What is that? Are they on the moon? Beautiful. Knowledge, I believe that's an Aquarius water sign. Knowledge. What Aquarius, Aquarius knowledge. Let's see. I want to look that up. Beautiful. Is that a six corresponds in love? Knowledge. Suit of water. Knowledge. Yes, it says Mercury in Aquarius. It says science, the search for truth, understanding, insight, intelligence. Or on a negative side, it could be weakness, blind spots, distrust, and skepticism. It says we search for the truth and strive for objectivity, understanding, and intelligence. The card may signify sudden blazing insight and unconventional solutions to problems. A satellite flies high above the planet, gathering data that is only visible for an enormous, I think it's going to say altitude. Yeah, altitude that becomes measurable and understandable precisely because of the separation between the observer and the observed. Ooh, knowledge. We search for truth and strive for objectivity, understanding, and intelligence. The card may signify sudden blazing insights and unconventional solutions to problems. So, what did I say? Your end result is knowledge. So when it all goes down, you're gonna be more wiser in any kind of, you get close to a situation like this, it's gonna be easy. Because you're gonna gain so much knowledge from what your current situation and what you're going through. Wonderful. Thank you guys for tuning in. Blessings to all my kings and queens. Grand rising all day, every day. I love you guys. Peace.